Hello and welcome to a new video from my YouTube channel, which is called Kalash Garage. Today, from my point of view, it's a special video because I will show you something that really helped me to save money, to save time, and also to be more confident in tackling all kinds of mechanical problems. So before I start, I just want to say, if you like my channel, if you like my videos and you find them useful, please support my channel and click the subscribe button. So in today's video, I will show you how you can resurface your head cylinder at home with a cost less than 10 euros. So I have tested this method on my last rebuild engine, on my Skoda 140 LSE engine. And I want to say that it's 100% bulletproof. I have rebuilt the engine last year in November. And since then I have covered more than 10,000 kilometers or approximately 6,000 miles. I have been in 5 foreign countries with the car and I didn't have any mechanical failure. I will post in the comment section some of the links with the restoration projects or how the car runs with the current engine, so you can check and see that this is the real deal. Okay, so many of you now will think, why the heck I should resurface the head cylinder at home when I can do this on a workshop with a cost of 20 or 30 euros? Well, the answer is very simple, because if you do this on your head cylinder, if you resurface your head cylinder at home, you can tackle also your engine block. You can resurface any area on your engine block as well. So keep that in mind, that the cost rises. The second good reason is the time. Just think about it. You can resurface your head cylinder in about, let's say, 2 hours. 2 hours, I think it's a decent time to do this. If you want to do this on a workshop, generally the workshop doesn't resurface your head cylinder immediately. It takes about at least 1 or 2 weeks to do that. And the third thing is, of course, you become more confident. So if you resurface your head cylinder by yourself, then you can tackle other problems. You can do your valve seats and so on. So basically you save more money, more time, and you become more confident. You need just some basic things. You need a drill machine, you need soft wire brush, you need some tape, some measure gauge, some device that is flat. I don't know the name of that device. A flat device, I'll call it like that, to check if the head cylinder is perfectly flat. But also you need some thick glass, like I have here. I think it's probably 5 or 6 millimeter thick. But also you need some sandpaper. You need with sandpaper with the values 100, 200, 400, and 600. Generally, when you reach the value of 600, it means that the head cylinder is as smooth as possible. And many of you are asking, why glass? Because glass is the flattest thing that you can find. Glass is something that is cheaper, something that you can find very easy, and you can use it on this procedure. So this is the introduction. I will go to the next step, in which I will show you how you can do this. The first thing that you need to do is to tackle your head cylinder, to remove all the parts,